Welcome to Essentials of Acute Care. I am Dr. Sunil Garg, and today I am going to discuss about permissive hypercapnia. Here it is important to understand that permissive hypercapnia is a ventilatory strategy and it is not the initial therapeutic goal. Aim of permissive hypercapnia is to reduce the risk of mechanical ventilation, so it is permitted, allowed, accepted at the expense of preventing lung injury. The rise in the CO2 is consequent to the ventilatory strategy. Now we will see how it is being done. Hypercapnia, as we discussed, it is tolerated rather than being a ventilatory goal per se. Tidal volume and or respiratory rate is decreased to reduce the adverse consequences of mechanical ventilation on diseased lung. So whenever we decrease the tidal volume and respiratory rate, CO2 increases. There is no set guidelines on ideal degree of reduction of either parameters. Monitor the effect of reduction of respiratory rate and tidal volume on arterial carbon dioxide and pH 1 to 2 hours after ventilatory adjustment. Means whenever you make any adjustment in the ventilatory settings, either you change the respiratory rate or tidal volume, you need to monitor the pH and the arterial carbon dioxide 1 to 2 hours after adjustment. Rapid changes in the ventilatory settings should be avoided. It means no greater than 2 to 3 breaths per minute below the set rate at a time, or no greater than 25 to 50 ml breath in tidal volume below the set volume should be done at a time. There is no absolute level of arterial carbon dioxide tension above which it should not rise, but levels higher than 100 mm of mercury are generally not required. Means there is no upper limit of CO2 where we should stop the procedure or we should not go beyond that. And there is no consensus regarding the acceptable lower limit for the pH. Now we will see when it is done and why it is done. It is done in the ARDS patient with the low tidal volume ventilation, and the rise in the CO2 in such patient is consequent to low tidal volume ventilation. The aim is to prevent the lung injury. It is also done in asthma and COPD exacerbation patient, those who are on mechanical ventilation, and aim is to minimize the intrinsic PEEP by reducing the tidal volume and or respiratory rate. These patients have expiratory airflow obstruction and are risk of intrinsic PEEP. It is also done in patients with bronchopleural fistula while managing these patients with the reduced ventilation. And the aim in such patient is to reduce the air leak and to help in healing of the bronchopleural fistula. Though considered safe for the most patients, permissive hypercapnia should be avoided in certain categories if feasible, which includes patients with the acute cerebral disease, patient with the coronary artery disease and heart failure, patient who are at risk or patient who has arrhythmias, patient with the pulmonary hypertension with the right ventricular failure, and it should also be avoided in the hypovolemic patients. And if it is done in the hypovolemic patient, hypovolemia should be corrected before going for the permissive hypercapnia. Hope you find this video useful. If you have any feedback, suggestion in the comments, you can write down in the comment section box. Once again, thanks for watching this video.